What is sound? This initially sounds like a trivial question. We all know what sound is. But if we're hoping to create sound, either through software or electronics, it's important to have a clear understanding of what sound is so we can effectively generate and modify it. So hi, this is Simon, and this is a short video defining sound with an eye to thinking about how to synthesize it. The definition of sound that I operate with is this: a vibration in a physical medium as perceived by the ear. I like this definition because it's concise, but it also contains a number of important points. First, that sound is a vibration. Since it's a vibration, sound physically depends on change over time, specifically molecules getting compressed together and then decompressed apart. High pressure to low pressure to high pressure to low pressure. If there's no change in that compression, if we stop moving at any point at a given high pressure, low pressure, or at rest, there's no vibration and therefore no sound. This brings us to the part of the definition about a physical medium. Something needs to vibrate, and if there's no physical medium, there can be no sonic vibration. I'm sure you all know someone who loves to watch sci-fi movies and make the comment that lasers wouldn't make any sound in space, or something like that. Whether or not these comments are useful, they're correct. Since the vacuum of space has no air, or other medium, there are no molecules that can compress and decompress and transfer sound. Other kinds of waves, radio waves and other electromagnetic radiation, can travel through a vacuum because they aren't transmitted by compression or decompression of molecules. We say a vibration in a physical medium here instead of a vibration in air because sound can vibrate through media besides air. We can hear sound when we're underwater in the pool, and you might have seen in old Western movies people listening to horses by putting their ears on the ground or trying to tell if a train is coming by putting their ear on the track, which I don't recommend. Finally, the definition specifically mentions perception by the ear. This is important. There are lots of vibrations occurring around us that we cannot hear. One reason that we can't hear them is our ears can only perceive a limited range of frequencies, vibration speeds. We can generally hear sounds from 20 vibrations per second to 20,000 vibrations per second, 20 to 20,000 hertz. There's some variation in this, of course, with young people tending to hear higher, and us losing the upper range of these frequencies as we get older. This fact has been implemented in a couple ways, including an alarm or ringtone that only young people can hear, as well as anti-loitering devices that play sustained high-pitched tones so young people won't congregate in certain areas. Just for reference, here's a sound at 50 hertz. Here's a vibration at 5 hertz, which we probably can't call a sound because we can't perceive it with our ears. Let's try with some high frequencies. I actually don't know about what YouTube does to audio once I've uploaded it, so the high frequencies might be lost somewhere in the encoding process already. But here's 16,000 hertz. And here's 20,000 hertz. Outside of humans, different animal ears hear differently too, with dogs, for example, hearing from 64 hertz to 44,000 hertz, depending on breed. This is why we can make dog whistles that humans can't hear, because they're above the 20,000 hertz threshold of our hearing, but not above the 44,000 hertz threshold of a dog's hearing. You can check out the diversity of hearing ranges of different animals with a quick Google search. But back to us humans, I'm not a philosopher, but according to our definition then, if a tree falls in the woods and there's no one to hear it, it doesn't make a sound, since we've included perception in our definition. Setting aside how you feel about the philosophy of that question, this idea is important for us in the synthesis of sound. We can create vibrations in a physical medium all day long, but if we're making them at 5 hertz, imperceptible to the ear, it's hard to claim we're creating sound. Similarly, if we create a vibration at an imperceptible amplitude, or at a frequency above the range of human hearing at 40,000 hertz, we might still be able to make the argument that we're doing synthesis for dogs or something, but we're certainly not synthesizing sound as humans understand it.